right, so I have just done the warm-up and the isolation, so I'm good and sweaty, and I hope that if you're doing this video that you're going to be good and sweaty too, because you never want to start stretching until your body is fully warmed up. Okay, so if you're not sweating, you're not ready to stretch. Okay, if you are ready to stretch, here's how we start it. Wide second position, arms reaching out to the side, second position. You're going to spread your fingers, spread your arms, and reach out to the side. Really open your chest up so you don't want to collapse over. Really open to the audience and pull with both arms. From here, you're going to go into flat back. So over to the side. Think of your spine pulling out of your head. So no cheating with heads up like this. This is not flat. You're going to make it like a table, super flat. Keep that back flat, pressing down, not like this. Super, super flat. From here, you go down to your leg, pull yourself in as close as you can. Try and relax the neck. You go to the center, again, relax the neck, pull yourself in. You go to the other side, again, relax the neck, pull yourself in. From here, you go flat back to the other side, pulling out of your spine, nice and flat here. Turn to the side, again, stretching your arms, stretching your fingers, leaving your chest open to the audience, and then back up again. Then we reverse that to the other side. From there, we go into lunge. So lunging, make sure that you have your knee directly over your heel. You don't want to go too far forward because that puts too much stress on your joints. So nice and even here, 90 degree angle, and your back leg is as straight as it can go while you're pressing your hips down to the ground. This should be stretching your hip flexor right here, the front of your hip. So from here, we're going to go up, and the wider you leave your legs, the better. Depends on your flexibility. If you can just leave your legs really wide, you can get a nice stretch. Straightening both legs, keeping both feet parallel, so your toes and your heels are in line, facing the side wall. You're pressing down into that back heel to get a calf stretch, and you're also getting a nice hamstring stretch in this front leg, okay? But make sure you're not opening it up. Make sure you keep it squared off to that side wall. From here, we're gonna go back down again into lunge. Stay here for a second. You're gonna put your knee down with your right hand. You're gonna reach backwards to the back of the room, and you're gonna grab the toe. Pulling this leg in and pressing this hip down, you get a really nice quad stretch on the front of your leg. Now you might get a hamstring cramp here. If that happens, just release it for a few seconds and try again. But you shouldn't be using your muscles at this point. You should be using your hand to pull in, okay? From here, you're gonna slide that knee backwards to the back of the room. So now I'm facing the back. Putting both hips on the ground, you're gonna take your arm and twist your torso to the front as much as you can. Try to look at yourself in the mirror or try to look at whatever wall you're facing away from. From here, you're gonna go over your legs, trying again to keep both hips on the ground. You should feel a nice stretch in your hips and your gluteus maximus. You can also, at this point, my hips are really bad, so I just do some bulk over here and that gives me a nice stretch. But if your hips are very flexible, you can also do the yoga pose, like so, and go over. Like I said, my hips are really bad, so I don't do that one. So from here, you do your stretch back, you do your stretch over, and you're gonna go back onto that knee, facing the same way you were facing with your lunge. You're gonna put your leg out front. This side, the first side, it's gonna be your right leg out front. From here, you're gonna push back into your hips to again get a nice hamstring stretch in that right leg. So push back, hold this for a little while. From here, you're gonna slide into your splits. If you do not have your splits, hold yourself up wherever you are, but hold yourself here. Doing this and relaxing with your knees bent is not gonna help you get your splits, okay? When you're relaxed, you're not working. So hold yourself up. Hold it, hold it. You have to hold it for a few seconds, otherwise you're not gonna get anywhere. Now, if you have your splits, take this opportunity to do whatever you need to do for your body. You can go over the front, you can arch back, you can lift the leg in the back, you can go off the side of your leg here. There's lots of things you can do. Know your body, know yourself, know what you need, okay? After a while, we're gonna relax, turn around, and to go to the other side where we start with a lunge again. So we'll repeat that whole thing on the left side. When we're in our left splits, we're going to come to the front for center splits. Center splits, legs are as far apart as you can go while sitting up straight. So if you have to hunch over, that's not it. Bring your legs a little bit closer so that you can sit up nice and straight. Legs are straight, feet are pointed, and I've got the turnout activated. So I'm squeezing back here to keep my legs rotated out. I'm gonna reach over just like standing, reaching through, opening the chest up so my shoulders are stacked right on top of each other, not here. Okay, same thing on the other side. Reaching, reaching, keeping the opposite hip on the ground. Don't cheat by lifting. Then we're gonna twist and go over. So your goal is to put your chest on your leg here. Be careful that this leg doesn't twist backwards. That leg has to remain turned out. Okay, so keep that hip on the ground. Same thing, other side. Watch this leg, chest, hip, leg. Then we come up and we go forward. Walk your hands as far forward as you can go while keeping that turnout happening in your legs. So don't let your legs relax over. Keep pushing. They might go forward a little bit, that's okay, but keep pushing backwards as much as you can. Every exhale, so when you breathe in, you breathe out, walk forward a little bit more. Yeah? Use the space that your lungs create to increase your flexibility. From here, we're gonna put our legs together, sitting up nice and tall, straight legs, pointed feet. We're gonna reach up and go over. Your goal here is to use your arms to pull yourself forward. Your goal is to put your head on the tips of your toes. That's not physically possible, right? However, that's what you should be thinking about. So instead of hunching over like this, think about going forward to your toes. Okay? Use your arms to pull yourself. Relax your neck, relax your head. After a few seconds, we're gonna come up, we're gonna flex our feet, grab your toes, and push your chest and your back forward. You should feel a really good stretch all the way down the back of your leg doing this. And then we go back again, and flex again. Just like in your center splits, whenever you're doing an exercise with stretching, use your breath. So right here, if I'm at capacity, I have my lungs full. When I exhale, my chest gets smaller. So I'm gonna use that space that's created to pull myself a little bit closer each time. You gotta actively stretch if you wanna make any progress, okay? So that's it for our first stretch combination. We'll do it with music. I'll face the back so you can follow along with me, if you'd like.
Yeah. She gives me love and affection. Baby, did I mention you're the only girl for me that I don't need a next one? Mama loves you too, she thinks I made the right selection. Now all that's left to do is